We're shaking, people. Back with another reaction, back with some more ABBA. I did want to start by giving a big shout out to all the ABBA friends who've become part of this channel. The ABBA Deep Dive has really become a place where not only are there enthusiastic comments about the different songs and albums, but people informing each other, you know, fans learning from each other. I'm going through this experience being largely ignorant of their music, so now having come through multiple albums, I have a much greater understanding and appreciation for who ABBA is and why they have been such a phenomenon, even during the years when they weren't making music. And indeed, I'm really looking forward not only to the next album, certainly, but I am really excited to hear recent ABBA when we get to that point. So, bottom line, I'm here for the full journey. More and more, it seems like a number of people have become part of this, so big ups to all of you. Big shout out to Eduardo, who sort of brought that to my attention. You know, I was aware that the videos were getting a lot of views and a lot of interest from ABBA fans, but I hadn't quite realized like how significant that was, so shout out to you for bringing that to my attention. And yeah, the the next tune on their 1980 album Super Trouper is On and On and On, which speaks to something that is continuous. There's no defined ending point, it is everlasting perhaps. Now, there's all sorts of things that jump to mind there. Maybe the way of human relations, the experiences, the emotions that people have. Perhaps this is something that just goes on and on and on. At the very least, that's where my mind is thinking after going through The Winner Takes It All, which admittedly, a number of you commented on how special that tune is, and a few of you said it's even hard to listen to because it's so deep with emotion. I certainly felt that, but it's funny because there have been reactions in different playlists that have moved me to the point of weeping on camera, which is a weird thing, right? Like, for many years, music moves me very deeply, different kinds of music, and I have headphones on, and I go through that experience. But now that I shoot these videos, when it happens, it's like, oh man, like, I hope I don't lose it too much. But I'm also experiencing that moment and genuinely feeling those feelings, so it's an odd thing. But, it's happened enough times now that I know I just have to run with it. But it's funny, because I was feeling those lines and the deep pain. I know what it's like to be at the end of a relationship where you're like, I mean, I don't even know what to say. Like, I know the way I feel, and I know this isn't going to work, but like, I know those types of feelings. And so I was feeling those moments, but then Anita's vocals just, like, they were so powerful and, you know, bounding over the top of the tune that I think my brain was arrested. So it was an interesting experience because, again, a number of you commented that, you know, you can't get through that tune without crying, and I certainly get that. I absolutely do, but again, like, thinking about the reaction in the song, I think it was because every time I started to really key in on the lyrics and feel that emotion, those vocals would just take over my brain and arrest everything else. So, in any case, I am curious to hear, you know, whether On and On and On may have something to do with emotional and interpersonal dynamics. It could relate to some other process seen as immutable and unchanging. It could relate to your own attitude about something, just, you know, I'm going to continue to go on and on despite setbacks or any problems. I feel like it's a phrase that could work in so many different ways. Let's find out what it is. This is ABBA, On and On and On, and it's from the 1980 album Super Trouper.
I was at a party.
psychedelic vocals.
Over in the corner, I can see this other guy.
These sections feel a bit new wave. And elements never ceases to amaze. It's another one where I'm feeling the pop rock vibes, but the beginning of the verses felt very new wave, a bit of that synth sound. Even the vocal delivery in that sections was a bit, I don't know, like not robotic, but it was a bit more in that new wave style where it's like, again, not monotone, but it's like a stripped down kind of vocal delivery. But then they go big and expansive in those choruses, and I love the backing angelic vocals, which had a bit of a gospel quality, even though like in the mix they were just a supporting element. Again, just the composition of their tunes is remarkable, and you know, then we can talk about the voices, then we can talk about, I am hearing more synth sounds, not just in that like new wave kind of section, but those big sweeping synth bass parts, which again made me think of Vangelis and his, you know, like Creation du Monde or something like that. And again, that comparison in my brain, I assure you, is a very positive one. So I'm hearing like wheelhouse or hallmark ABBA, but I'm also hearing some tidbits that do lend substance to what people have said about this album. So again, feeling the dance vibes, feeling the pop rock vibes, feeling all different flavors as we go through even just one song on this album. So again, shout out to all the ABBA people. Really do appreciate the support of the channel. Do let me know what you think of this one, and I will see you next time. Peace.